The BAC-5051E is a multi-port BACnet router full of integrated features. This compact router is powerful enough for heavy network traffic when permanently installed and small enough to be carried as a technician service tool. Let's take a look specifically at the diagnostic features of this router through its integrated HTML5 web pages. To connect to the router, type the router's IP address in a web browser and log in. The integrated network diagnostics fall into five categories: routing status, device status, token use, MSTP metrics, and MSTP capture. From these, you can discover a number of network metrics including total number of devices, the average token cycle time, the average token time per device, and the last max master in use. Each of these is helpful in evaluating overall network performance. Once you're logged into the router, you'll see these options in the left-hand menu. First, let's look at the routing status. In the menu, this is found under routing, and this is the primary source to see what networks the router is connected to and their general status. Once the page is loaded, you will see a list of all of the known BACnet networks to this router. Networks designated directly connected are enabled by this router. Remote networks are enabled and controlled by other BACnet routers. Based on this, we know that this router is connected to these networks and is continuing to route data properly. If there are errors on the network, the status legend will help you determine what the error might be. Green is good. Looking back at the navigation, the remaining network diagnostics are found under the Diagnostics page. The next diagnostic tool is Device Status. This page offers a more detailed look at the MSTP network communication and its devices. This easy-to-read, color-coded chart shows the status of each of the connected devices. The router itself is shaded in blue. Green means a device at that specified MAC address is connected and communicating normally. White means there has not been a device discovered at that MAC address. Red shows multiple devices are sharing the same MAC or other errors are being discovered. Gray means an existing device has gone offline. As you can see, this page is extremely helpful in quickly identifying that devices are online, and if everything is green, you can use the next tool to determine the network communication efficiency. This page also gives average metrics for all devices on the network. These averages depend somewhat on the BACnet unit's vendors. On average, the token cycle time should be no more than 15 milliseconds per device. If it is, then this is a hint that there is probably more traffic than there should be. The average token cycle time per device should also be less than 10 milliseconds, typically. The next tool is token use. This window shows each of the device's speed of MSTP token passing. Like the device status page, this chart is color-coded. Once again, blue represents the router itself. In times of heavy traffic, this could change to green or yellow. Green means normal token passing, less than 100 milliseconds. Yellow shows potential bottlenecks, with the device token passing slower than 100 milliseconds, but currently still functioning. Red tells you that device is retaining the MSTP token longer than a period set by the APDU property. Typically, this is caused by excessive polling for data or discovery messages. Light blue shows the devices polling for the next master device. This typically happens if there are gaps in the MSTP MAC addresses or the MAC's master property may have been misconfigured. Our next diagnostic tool is metrics. This shows a quick list of MSTP statistics that help evaluate the overall network performance. The metrics count the messages being sent by or sent to the router, either directly or by using broadcast addresses. These numbers can identify some potential issues for troubleshooting. For example, this window shows the TX frame count and the TX data count. Together, this equals the total number of transmissions sent by the router. It also shows the RX frame count, which is the total number of frames received by the router. The total TX count should be slightly higher than the RX frame count. The router should be sending more messages than it receives, mainly because of token passing. If the received frame count is higher, then it's likely due to a device in the MSTP network that is trying to find another device that does not exist or could not be communicating properly. If any of the other counts on this page are more than 2 for every 10,000 received frame counts or 200 for every million, then you likely have noise in your network, shoddy wiring, or duplicate MACs. The last page under diagnostics is the MSTP capture. Here you can set up a data capture and save the BACnet traffic on the MSTP network. This allows you to capture 5 to 10 minutes of data depending on the baud rate and network traffic. captures may be uploaded in standard PCAT format. This format allows data to be uploaded for analysis in Wireshark, Visual BACnet, or any other network analysis program that uses PCAP files. These programs dig deeply into the data, assisting in difficult issue diagnostics. For more about the BAC-5051E router, please check out our other videos in this series. And to learn more about any of the solutions from the building geniuses at KMC, please visit us on the web at kmccontrols.com.